Hello, good morning everyone. Today is our next lecture on the subject of your machine design and environment. Myself, Dheeraj V. Ostrankar, assistant professor in Dr. Sir Kamalkar Gavai, Institute of Engineering and Technology, Dhaka. Okay, so in last lecture, we can discuss about the introduction of the design of shaft. In introduction of design of shaft, we can discuss about the definition, then material of the shaft, then types of the shaft. Then, in your design of shaft, there are the four types, and in that, in your first type, it's twisting moment only. We have already concluded in last lecture. So, today is our next lecture, and now we can start with your new subject. It's your shaft subjected to bending moment only. So previously we have concluded the one problem in your twisting moment only. In twisting moment only, we can see two types of the shaft, in solid shaft also, the hollow shaft also. Okay, at that time we are focus on the T, we are focus on the torque, but now it's a bending moment, so we can focus on the M. Okay, so in bending moment, we know the bending moments, then the moment of inertia. Then previously we can concentrate on your shear stress, because at the time of your torque, in twisting moment, we are required the shear stress, but now we can require the bending stress. So it's the sigma B. Okay. So, as per the solid shaft, T is equal to pi by 16 tau d cube. Okay, it's pi by 16 tau. Tau is your shear stress, but now it's the bending moment. So, bending moment will start from your notification is M. So, it's pi by 32 sigma b into d cube. This formula required for the bending moment, it's pi by 32 sigma b into d cube, and it's for the solid shaft. Then at the time of hollow shaft, we are required inside diameter and outside diameter also. So at the time of inside diameter and outside diameter, it's DO for your outside diameter. And DF for the inside diameter. So it's pi by 32 into sigma B DO to the power 4 minus DI to the power 4 upon DO. That's for the hollow shaft. Then at the time of your K, K is your, where K is your DI upon DO. It's the ratio of inside diameter upon outside diameter. So at the time of moment of inertia of hollow shaft, that is I, moment of inertia is always denoted as I, which is pi by 64. At the time of your m, bending moments which start from your m, it's pi by 32, but at the time of your moment of inertia, so it's pi by 64 d to the power 4 minus bi to the power 4 okay. Then at the time of your di upon do equal to k, so it's 5 by 64. Pi by 64 d to the power 4 minus 1 minus k. Why it is k? K is equal to di upon do. So it's k to the power 4. Okay. We are common ratio do. Sorry. Previously it's remaining is equal to do. It's I equal to pi by 64 do to the power 4 minus di to the power 4 upon do. So that's why pi by 64 do to the power 4, it's a common one. Then minus 1 minus k to the power 4. Why it is k? K, where k is the di upon do. Okay. Then, as per that, in previous lectures we have already discussed, it's not engineering mathematics, it's a machine design and drawing. So we are not required to remember all type of formulas, because as per the university norms, we have used the design data. At the time of your exam also, the permitted required in your design data by the author Mahadevan. Okay. So at the time of your solving the problems, we are check the formulas on your data book and then start to calculating the problems. But most important is what type of calculators you can apply. Because many times students can difficult problems. It's not the problem of problems. The problem is calculator, operating of the calculator. You can miss any sequence in the calculator, then it's a difficulty. Okay. So now we can start the problem. Okay. So now we can start our problem. So first, all students write down the problem. An axial of a railway wagon carries a load of 50 kN acting at a distance of 100 mm outside the wheel base. The gauge of the rail is 1.4 meter. Find the diameter of the axle between the wheels if the stress is not exceed 100 megapascal. What is the given one? Is two wheels in railway wagon, there are the two wheels in between the two wheels, the distance is your 1.4 meter. First one, we can write down what is the given one. In that first one is the railway wagon carries a load of 50 kilonewton. So it's W equal to 50 kilonewton. So it's 50 into 10 to the power of 3 newton. That's clear. Then what is the next one? A distance of 100 mm outside the wheelbase. From the wheel to the outside, its distance is your 100 mm. So it's your L equal to 100 mm. Then next one is 1.4 meter. 1.4 meter is the difference between the two wheels. 1.4 meter. Always remember that it's a 1.4 meter and L, the distance between wheel to outside, it's your in your mm. So first you can convert it that it's your 1400 mm, means your 1400 mm. The distance between two wheels is 1400 mm. Then most important is your bending stress. Bending stress is your 100 megapascal. So it's sigma b, it's 100 megapascal. 100 megapascal means 100 newton per mm square. We are required all in mm, and we are find out the diameter. The diameter of the shaft, it's also in your mm. Okay. So as per the given conditions and problem, first we can draw for the suppose these two wheels, which are in railway wagon. It's the diameter of the shaft. Then suppose it's not, then it's the center axis of your railway wheel, because they can give the distance from it's the outside of the wheel. It's already given, it's 100 mm. So it's 100 mm. That's also 100 mm. Then what is next one? Next one is the this distance in between the two wheels, and that is given is a 1.4 meter. It means 1400 mm. That's clear. Then the railway wagon carries a load is 50 kilonewton. So this load is 50 kilonewton. As like that. This load is given 50 kilonewton. Then suppose we can consider 1, 2, 3, 4. So it's A, B, C and D point. At the time of load on downward direction, so you are given the force on you all are the final year students, so you already know about that, the bending moment and all about that. Because previously in engine mechanics, then mechanics of material, after that machine design and drawing 1, theory of machine 1, theory of machine 2, we have already studied related that. And now we are in final year and it's your machine design and drawing. So it's not in detail, it's already known. Okay. So
these two levels, the difference between two levels, it's 1.4 meter distance, and the outer diameter is 100 mm. And we are calculating the diameter with the help of bending moment. So little consideration will show that the maximum bending moment acts on the wheel at B and C. Maximum moment acts on the wheel B and C. Okay, that's clear. Then, therefore, the maximum bending moment. So, maximum bending moment. Where is coming the bending moment? Load into length. Load and length. That's why on your B, it's your bending moment. They can bend. So it's M equal to W into L. M equal to W into L. W is already given. Load is also given. And your distance is also given. So its load is your 50 into 10 to the power 3. And L is your 100. So it's 50 into 10 to the power 3 into 100. It means it's 5 into 10 to the power 6 Newton mm-hmm. mm-hmm. You can check on your the calculator also the value is same or not. Then now we can calculate the diameter of the shaft. So next one is the maximum bending moment. At that time, we are using the solid shaft. So it's M equal to pi by 32 into sigma b into d cube. So it's M equal to pi by 32 into sigma b into d cube. So for that, it's your pi by 32 into sigma b. Sigma b is 100. Into d cube and m we are already calculated that it's your 5 into 10 to power 6. So after that, the calculating of the diameter, it's your 79.85 mm. The diameter of the shaft is 79.85 mm. So now it's complete? No, it's not complete. As per the mathematical calculations, it's completed. But we are not only the mathematical calculations, we are designing the shaft. So after that, as per the ISO notations, we can check with your design data book. So in the design data book, table number 3.5a, they can show the design value of your shaft. They are write down number of values. You can check the near about value of your 79.85, but it's the height upper value of your 79. So after checking your data book, we check from data book. After checking the data book, you can notice that it's available, it's 80 mm. 80 mm is the higher than 79.85 and nearer to 79. So we can write down the diameter of the shaft, which is your 80 mm. As for that, whenever you are calculating the design of shaft, first you can calculate the diameter, then what is the nearest and highest value of that you can use. Okay, so I think now you can
stop for today's lecture. In next lectures, we can study the sharp subject to combine twisting moment and bending moment. In previously we can discuss about the twisting moment only. Now we can discuss about the bending moment, and next lecture the combined twisting and bending moment. Okay, thank you to all of you.